Okay, so today you're going to be working on this, and of course it's digital for you, but you're going to be working on a mineral identification lab. And so let's review the last couple days of instruction. First of all, on a Monday, you worked on the difference between a rock and a mineral. And so the main key concept there is if you think of rocks like chocolate chip cookies, minerals would be the ingredients that make up those cookies. Another way to say that is minerals are the building blocks of rocks, are the small parts that make them up. And so what we're going to be working on today is how to use mineral properties in order to identify and tell what mineral or rock building block is another way to think of a mineral that we have. And so you have a couple of things digitally that are going to be really necessary today. You have this chart on a PDF that says some common minerals. So this is basically acting like your choice bank, and it has characteristics or properties, we call them, of all sorts of minerals. You'll notice the ones that I've crossed out are ones that really we didn't learn about much with the notes, and so you don't have to consider those columns. The other thing that you have that's going to be important is this. This is based on Mohs hardness scale. Mohs was a guy that came up with this, and all minerals are somewhere between 1 and 10 on Mohs hardness scale. So you're going to be watching me, in this case, do a scratch test and figuring out just where your mineral falls in, and that can actually help you to identify your mineral. So I'm going to go through the same thing with three different minerals, and as you watch me go through it, of course, you can pause me, but you're going to be filling in all this different data and then using your chart to figure out what you think you have and why. I will tell you that I did not put any repeats in this, so all three minerals are three different ones. So let's go ahead and get started. And so this is our first mineral. This is mineral number one. Okay, and I wish that you could touch it, but I want you to take a good look at it. And the first thing that you're going to put down there is the color, and remember that it's describing the color on the outside. Okay? So next, let me show you the streak. So this is a ceramic streak plate, and it is actually what geologists or scientists would use to find the hardness of minerals. And so, or excuse me, I misspoke there completely. This is what they would use to find the streak of minerals. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to press on it with a streak, my mineral, hold the streak plate, press with my mineral, and then we're going to see what happens. Okay, so you're like, that is very weird. I don't see anything at all. And so what you do when that happens is you then have to rub the streak onto a darker surface, which I just did on my table, and there's nothing there. And so for our streak, the way I want you to say it is either clear or colorless. So we've got the color on the outside, and now we know we have a clear or colorless streak. Now, our next one is how would we say the luster of this mineral is? Luster means the way a mineral reflects light. And on your PDF, you can see that there are different types of lusters. Earthy actually means no luster at all. So watch this one in the light. We have earthy, glassy, pearly, metallic, which means it reflects light like a metal. So you're looking through waxy. You're looking through and thinking, well, which one do I think that mineral number one is most like? Okay, now after that, we just have a couple things to do left. The hardness test, and that's gonna be a scratch test. So you're gonna see me scratch with a few things and then refer to this chart. And then also a special property we're gonna investigate. So I'm gonna start by using a coin, a copper coin, and I am, which is a penny, I'm looking in here to see, does the mineral scratch with the coin? So I rub the coin on it, and I know it's probably tough for you to see, but as I rub this penny, there is no scratch. So you're going to say no there. Okay, and then now I'm taking out a steel nail. Okay, and I am doing the same thing. I'm scratching on it with a steel nail, and the answer again is no. So when we think of scratching, the resistance to scratching is what we're seeing with mineral one. So think about this. The resistance to being scratched, does that mean it's hard or soft if it's resisting? Now, that is almost the last thing for this mineral. The final thing is a special property. So minerals have special properties. Some of them glow under ultraviolet light, for example. Some of them have a unique taste. I'm not going to be tasting this mineral, but some of them will do a chemical reaction in an acid. So what I have here is vinegar, and I'm going to get my dropper full, and I'm going to put a couple drops is all it'll take on this mineral. And again, I know it's hard for you to see at home, but there are no bubbles that are being created. So when I put five or so drops on there, the answer to is there a chemical reaction is no. And so it's honestly up to you at this point. If you want to watch all three minerals and get the tests on all three minerals and then go back to this PDF and see what you think you have, or if you want to, you can right now at the end of this video figure out what you think mineral number one is, and then you have to back up what you think. You have to give a full sentence of why you thought that, like what was really the convincing factor.